when you wake up, you don't know.
So, everybody got their gloves?
Man. Old man Quillez is in there by himself. Let's do this.
Is everybody ready? Bishop?
Hell yeah.
Q? Steel. You all right, man? Come on, B, get it together, because we're really counting on you, okay? Here come the cops. Let's go.
Hey, we're closed. No more customers, that's it.
Freeze, motherfucker!
Detroit, y'all already know what it is. It's your number one brand ambassador in all the world, True Johnson, your True Boo. And we're back with your hit film show, Frame by Frame, the real deal in the movie world. And today we're going to be talking about some of my favorite urban films. We have our top five. We're going to be talking about Juice. Juice is one of my favorite urban bad guy, you know, kind of films. Like Tupac. I love Tupac. I love some of his music. I just loved him as an artist. I loved his work. But I hated him. Baby and Juice. I never thought that. I mean, Pac, forgive me for saying this, but I wanted to just. I mean, he was terrible. I just couldn't believe him. Like, he was terrible good, right? I mean, nobody ever really thought that, you know, Tupac had the skills to be such a great actor, but, you know, I mean, everybody say that, yeah, that's, he was a thug for real, that's why he played it so good, you know, but no. A lot of those things in the movie that, you know, he did, he never really did in real life. But when I tell you I enjoyed him as that bad guy in Juice because he made me really feel emotion. I mean, he was just playing a character. Here it was, musician, somebody that was as talented a poet as Tupac was, activist, just a wonderful artist whom I still love and will always love. Rest in peace, Pac. He had so much talent, right? But he showed you that he could cross over. He could make you feel a different way about him because he made me hate him.
Turn around, hit the wall, quick!
Please, don't shoot.
Turn around, motherfucker!
I don't see nothing, look. I won't
shut the fuck up!
Please, am I crazy?
I give a fuck about you!
Look, take everything you want.
Shut the fuck up!
Please, just don't shoot me, that's all. Okay? You're not gonna shoot me, are you? Please don't shoot me, all right?
Just you don't shut the fuck up!
What's wrong with you? I'm not gonna shoot you!
You're gonna blow your ass away if you don't keep calm! Bring your ass to the fucking wall! Shut the fuck up, old man!
Yeah?
All right, let's go!
No, you're trying to go!
Love Tupac. He played Juice. He played the most hated character in the film. I mean, you know, it was one of my favorites for a lot of different reasons, because it showed the life of young African-American males, how they could get caught up in the streets. You know, they bought that pistol, they barely knew how to use it. And, you know, but Omar Epps, that's another one of my favorite actors that was in the film. Omar Epps, he played the DJ, you know, I loved him, his mixing skills, right? That was one of my favorite parts in the film. But again, I loved it because the message was showing how young African-American males can get caught up when living in the hood. You know, they don't have the right leadership. So hats off to Juice as our number five and our top five films, urban films, we're talking about today, our top five urban films, and we talked about the movie Juice. Do you got the juice? I love juice. And we ain't talking about O.J. Simpson, baby. We talking about Juice, the movie today, with Tupac Shakur, Omar Epps, and a lot of other of our favorite actors. And we'll be right back with your hit film show, Frame by Frame, the real deal in the movie world. And we're going to talk about one of my favorites when we come back, baby. Set it off. We're about to set it off.
Your brother. I'm sorry about Stevie. I'm sorry he's dead. I swear to God. But don't do this. Stevie was enough. He was enough. No more killing. Put the weapon down. Stevie was enough. Stoney, put it down. Come on. There you go. Cleo, come on. Come on.
What are you doing?
Today, we are giving you our top five urban films, and we're back setting it off, talking about Set It Off with three of my favorite ladies, Queen Latifah, Vivica Fox, and Jada Pinkett Smith. I mean, come on. Where do I start? Because I love all of them, right? Vivica Fox, she's the only one who didn't do music, or I don't know, maybe she has some hidden talent when it comes to music, but you know, Queen Latifah, y'all know Queen is the queen. That's right, a queen recognized a queen. So shout out to Queen Latifah and Jada Pinkett. Love Jada Pinkett Smith. She did a lot of movies that I loved her in, but we're gonna talk about Set It Off. I loved Set It Off because y'all already know I'm a thug, baby. I'm a thug. Y'all know True Blue, no. I'm not a thug, but you know, I got a little thug up in me, right? You know what I'm saying? I mean, when it's time for me to be street, I know how to do that. Coming from an urban area, because I'm from the hood, let's face it, I'm gonna keep it real. That's why y'all love me, because that's what I do. I keeps it real. So we're keeping it real here today on The Real Deal in the Movie World, your hit film show frame by frame, and we're talking about our top five urban films. I love Set It Off because, you know, it just really showed you the truth about how we can feel when we feel pressed for money, you know. I mean, don't get it twisted, baby, because I'm never robbing a bank, okay? I'm too scared. I don't want to go to jail. So I'm going to tell you right now, I got to think of some other ways to make money. But when it comes to making films, they made a great film with Set It Off. I love Set It Off. I loved Vivica A. Fox and Set It Off. You know, it really pissed me off when they fired her because, you know, she didn't do anything. You know, she just knew the guy. And there it is. It shows you that, you know, you're guilty by association, especially when working for an establishment such as a bank. And then being an African-American woman, the robber being African-American. So, you know, it just showed you so many different points in the movie, considering what we have been through and what we're still going through with all of this craziness that's been going on. With the mistreatment of African Americans. And so in that film, it showed you how one could be discriminated against in a situation that literally was not her fault. Even though she knew him, it wasn't her fault. He targeted her. So what I loved about it is, you know, it just showed you, yeah, I mean, if that was you, you might feel that way too. If you got fired, you know, you don't have any money, and you know, boom, bam, boom, next thing you know, you talk your girls into robbing the bank, and baby, they set it off. And Queen Latifah, you know, she did such a great job. Man, I loved her in that film. I loved when she fired the gun inside of the garage, okay? Jada Pinkett had to tell her, sit, Cleo. Sit. Do you hear me? Because she was like a mad dog. She was ready to kill. You hear me? I love Queen Latifah. Shout out to her. So, man, I love Set It Off for so many reasons. And then the other girl that was in there, let me see if I can ask my producer what her name is. What's her name? Elise. Forgive me for not knowing her name. But, you know, I have to remember so many things. But I know her face. I know her talent. I love her. The little chocolate one who had the son, you know, she felt like, you know, I gotta do this for my baby, you know. She was the timid one, right? Let's just keep it real. That's not me. I could have never played that role, right? I probably would have been Cleo or Vivica Fox if I would have played and Set It Off, you know. I love the way, you know, they did that thing when they busted up out of there in the I think that was a Suburban they was driving, right? They busted up out of there in the Suburban. And I mean, they just set it off. The movie had you hyped. Just thinking about it has me hyped, right? It's a movie that you can go and just watch again and again if you're just, you know, trying to find something to pass the time, especially since we've been in this quarantine. I don't suggest that you watch movies all day. You know, do something constructive with your time, work on your business, your talent. But at the same time, if you want to have a little fun, which we all need to do, that's why we love entertainment and movies. And I do love a great movie, and Set It Off was a great one. It was one of my favorites, a wonderful urban film. So I want you to stay put, don't move a muscle, get your popcorn and get something to drink, and we'll be back with our number three favorite, Menace to Society, baby. We not even gonna go there. Just don't move a muscle. You have tuned in to Frame by Frame, The Real Deal in the Movie World, with your number one brand ambassador in all the world, True Johnson. We'll be right back.
What are you saying, baby?
You.
Who you think you are?
Why don't you
nobody
get a job?
Hey, look, Damon, why don't you go ahead and get us money,
y'all
dog?
Y'all sell for my money. Like,
hey, look, why don't you just go ahead and hook us up, Damon? What you waiting on?
Girl, you didn't hook us up 50 million times. What you talking
I'm tired of hooking your sorry ass up. Go get a goddamn
sorry.
Job. That's what
hey,
you do,
hey,
so you can pay for some of this shit.
Hey, man, I don't even sweat this bitch, man. Pick your big earring ass and go get us something to eat, all right?
Fuck you,
nigga,
okay?
Fuck you, and fuck you, okay?
Y'all niggas, hurry up. Go in there, buck them niggas, and get the fuck out. And don't be playing. Dog Kane, you hear what I'm saying? Kill them niggas and get the fuck back so we can stab out. I'm gonna be chilling right here.
Hey, nigga, I wanna know if you ready to do this shit.
Is you ready to do this shit or what, motherfucker? And don't be acting like no pussy when we get the fuck out there.
Hey, dog, you wanna go to my house? My mom had a big ass pot
of chili. Yeah, nigga, that's rest of them chili. Nigga, we don't need no motherfucker.
That's where y'all asses need to be in the goddamn house. You know you got a curfew.
Why don't you take us and get us a motherfucking burger or something, stupid ass bitch?
Fuck you, nigga. It's time for both of y'all to go, okay?
Let's get off mom's house, nigga. We don't need this shit.
That's what I'm saying.
Go home to your mammies, okay?
Yeah, nigga, break your motherfucker. Bitch, shut the fuck up before we blast your ass, too. Shut the fuck up.
Hey, homie, you need some help? Punk ass nigga, come on, niggas.
Frame by frame, Detroit, y'all already know what it is. We're back. You have tuned in to your hit film show with your queen of television, your number one brand ambassador in all the world, True Johnson, your True Boo. And we're back with number three, Menace to Society. Oh my God. Who wants a menace to society? Who wants to be a menace? Oh my goodness. That movie, Menace to Society, is still one of the most watched, you know, kind of like urban crime films, just next to what we talked about, Juice. You know, it's kind of a similar thing, but we're going to talk about Old Dog today. He got on my nerve with them braids. I mean, he was just a menace. He was a mess. Okay, I don't know, you know, and I loved him in so many movies. And then we're back on my girl Jada Pinkett. We just talked about her, Jada Pinkett Smith. I mean, she was good to me in so many different films. And we're talking about Menace to Society. I kind of loved her because she played like, you know, that innocent type girl in the hood, you know, got a kid, you know, want to get out the hood, you know, got a little sense, but trapped, you know. But I love Menace to Society, you know, one of my favorite parts. Hurry up and bite. Hurry up and bite and go. Hurry up and go. Boom. What you say about my mama? Let me quit. Woo. Y'all, if y'all hear some snickering in the background, that's probably just my producer laughing at me, you know, because, man, I love that part, you know, because again, it just depicted, you know, how you can go from 0 to 100 when, you know, when being antagonized, you know, just playing the race issue is just, you know, when you see that, you know, type, the, you know, the urban type, thug type, you know, they popping open the beer, you know, drinking it in the store, all of that craziness, you know, but those are the things you deal with when you in the hood, you know. And Menace to Society was about a film in the hood, you know, the real depiction of the things that happen in the hood, you know. Shoot, I mean, you got to be careful what you say about people. What you say about my mama? You cannot say nothing about nobody. Mama in the hood, hurry up and buy, hurry up and go. Those Chinese people don't want you doing nothing in that store. And still to this day, they treat you like that right now. Don't get me started on the Chinese people and the way they treat us in their establishments. 2020. Okay? This movie was a while ago, but we're talking about today, the prevalence of what we are fighting still to this day and battling as African Americans, that which I am. You can see my skin is melanated. I'm proud to be a woman of color. And you know, I just want to say to my other sisters and brothers of color, be proud of who you are and work that thing. Your gift looks good on you, okay? Be proud to be an African American. So we're talking about Menace to Society today. And you know, I love Menace to Society because it was just, you know, a good banger film. I mean, you know, of course I wouldn't want any of those things to happen in real life, but we're talking about film today. And I love the way, you know, that they just dug into what really goes on in the hood, you know, and they had that great acting in there. Shout out to everybody in Menace to Society. And you're watching frame by frame the real deal in the movie world, your hit film show with your number one brand ambassador in all the world, True Johnson, your True Boo.
Somebody must have been praying for that fool. Cause I swear I aimed right for his head.
Should have blew it off.
Don't say that. Don't say that. You just would have been contributing to killing another brother.
And where are these fools? We've been waiting out here for almost an hour, you know that? Burglary here?
Yeah, that was about an hour ago.
Whoa. We didn't ask you that.
Yeah, well, I told you. Besides, I don't like having my son out here in the cold.
Just tell me what happened, sir.
Well, somebody broke into the house. I fired at him with my piece, and he ran away.
So you didn't get him?
Well, if I got him, he'd be laid out here in front of you, right?
Is there anything missing?
No.
Good. No need to make out a report.
12 out of 65. We've got a 415 on Florence between Vermont and Normandy.
You know, it's too bad you didn't get him. Be one less nigga out here in the streets we have to worry about. Hey, little man. How you doing?
Going in the house, Trey. Go on.
Something wrong?
Something wrong, yeah. It's just too bad you don't know what it is. Brother.
Star-studded, baby, okay? Y'all already know what I'm talking about. Ice Cube, Cuban Gooding Jr., Morris Chestnut. Baby, go on and say it. Boys in the hood! About Boys in the Hood. I cannot even name all of the great stars in Boys in the Hood. I mean, I know I'm missing somebody, so if I forget to mention somebody, forgive me, okay? Because I love everybody in there, starting with the mama, okay, of Morris Chestnut. That's my girl. Y'all already know who it is, but I'm not the greatest with names, you know, but y'all know who I'm talking about. I just loved her. She has been in a lot of films too, so, but Boys in the Hood was one of my favorites with her. And one of the parts that really tugged on my heart was, of course, when they killed Morris Chestnut. Y'all know I didn't want them killing that fine black man, okay? Black, baby, we love black. The blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice, y'all know. And Morris Chestnut was dark, baby. And Boys in the Hood, he wasn't even bothering nobody, and here we go getting murdered. And let me tell you, even though they depict these things in films and they make it entertainment, it's real life. Okay, our black men are extinct damn near. I mean, if they're not in jail, they're either dead or somewhere else that I'm not going to mention. But we know, you know, we have a serious issue when it comes to protecting our African American males. And, you know, in the hood is one of the most scariest places for a young African American male to grow up. So if you out there and you graduated in 2020 and you're doing good, trying to do big things, and you're African American male, shout out to you. If you're a graduate period in 2020, shout out to you, but especially my African American males. I loved Boys in the Hood for so many different reasons. You know, Cuban Gooding Jr., I loved him. I loved the role that he played. Oh man, then I forget Nia Long. We can't forget Nia Long. You know, they played boyfriend and girlfriend. I love those two together. You know, I love the scene. Lawrence Fishburne was his father. You know, finally, you know, he had to get out of there. Angela Bassett got tired of him. You know how it be. Mothers, y'all know when you raising a boy by yourself. Trust me, I know all too well how difficult it could be. So she sent him to live with his father. I think Trey was his name. You know, she sent him to live with his daddy, and you know, he called himself being grown, and he was on the phone with his boo talking about something. So when you gonna give me some of that? Hello, what? He was like, Mom? Yes, you still on the phone with your mama. So, you know, you gotta make sure you click over, but you know, we have cell phones nowadays, so we don't really go through that anymore. But that was one of my favorite scenes. I loved Boys in the Hood, because it made me go through a series of emotions. And that's what I love about a great film. You know, it'll make you feel series of emotions, you know. And the thing is, the situation really doesn't exist. These are our great stars making these things come to life. At the same time, it's still real life, you know. So shout out to families out there who are recovering from this horrible COVID-19 pandemic. We're praying for those families that have lost their loved ones. We're praying for all of the families that have lost a loved one due to police brutality or any type of violence. We love you and we support you here on Frame by Frame, and we're working towards ending that whole situation entirety. Police brutality, any kind of evil, right? Y'all know what it is. So you have tuned in to Frame by Frame, your hit film show in all the world, with your number one brand ambassador in all the world, the queen of television, your true boo. Don't move, okay? Because we're coming back with our number five. That's right, I saved the best for last. You probably know where I'm going with this one. Full of stars once again. You're a star, and you're watching Frame by Frame, the real deal in the movie world. We'll be right back.
Hey, dreadlocks. Where the bum buckle head on semis
over
and top
top of that bitch? Come here, man. Let me speak with you. Rasta man, I'm here to tell you Nino Brown says your services are no longer needed in the community.
Who the bum buckle at you?
Oh! Yeah! Now that's how you kill somebody, my brothers. You get right up on the motherfucker and bam! Throw his brains all over the sidewalk in broad daylight.
Drop the ball, baby.
My brother, I think there's been a little misunderstanding. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Now look, you are gonna give up those apartments.
Huh? Yes, sir.
And you are gonna turn over control of the Carter to the brothers.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes. Well, if we don't, I guess the shotgun goes off. It blows your big fat head off clean before you can get your clothes back on.
Yes, sir.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Living. Detroit, we're back. That's right. We're back with your hit film show, Frame by Frame, the real deal in the movie world, baby. And we setting it off. We back on black, and we proud to be black, baby. And we're talking about another black man today. Y'all already know what it is. Wesley Snipes, Nino Brown, New Jack City, baby. The Corridor, yo, baby. Woo! I just get hyped when I think about about this movie, okay? Because it touches me on so many different levels. I mean, I'm emotional when I think about this movie for so many different reasons, okay? Because the crack cocaine era, you know, was a horrible time. It destroyed families, legacies, and, you know, we won't even get on how the crack got here. We'll talk about that on a whole nother show. But right now, we brought you our number one, we say, for number one out of our top five, which is New Jack City. Oh my goodness. Baby, when he jacked that whole apartment building with that gun, when he had that gun on the guy, I said, Lord, woo! Too much, okay? Nino was just too damn much, okay? We hated him. And some people loved him, okay? Let me just tell you, sometimes I loved him and most times I hated him. I wanted to kill him when he used that little girl as a shield when they was trying to kill his butt, okay? I just wanted to cut him. Wesley Snipes, I just gotta take my hat off to Wesley Snipes because he's a great actor. I love him in so many different films. But I loved him in this film for so many different reasons because he showed you several different realms of emotion in this film. You know, I mean, you know, like he said, Miss Hawkins, he hawked with it. Hello? Baby, y'all know the part I'm talking about when he was at court? He said, yes, Miss Hawkins. Baby, he knew he was getting off. Next thing you know, when I tell you it did not work because my man came and shot him dead, okay? What goes around comes around. He just knew he was getting away with that, but I'm gonna tell you the truth. I'm about that vigilanteism, baby, okay? Especially when we talking about films. You hear what I'm saying? Idolater, you're an idolater. You gotta go, you hear me? So, you know, my man, he said, yeah, I might be old and frail, baby, but when I come with that shotgun, you ain't gonna know what hit you. He hit him with the element of surprise. Okay, Wesley Snipes thought he was getting off. And then let's talk about Chris Rock. Pookie them lips, baby, he still ain't recovered from them lips in that role. Let me tell you. Woo! I ain't gonna talk about Chris Rock, baby, but I'm gonna tell you the truth. He still ain't, baby, every time I see him, them lips look chapped. Even if they not chapped, I think they are. He still ain't recovered from that role. But don't get me wrong, I love Chris Rock. I'm just messing with you, Chris Rock. I'm just saying, don't call me and be talking junk, you know. But in that role, baby, he said he didn't want a piece of turkey. He wanted the whole damn turkey. And I loved Pain. You know, my man High Yellow, y'all know who I'm talking about. You know, he started messing with that glass. You know what, we can't say that word here, but he started messing with that crack. That crack was and still is and always will be the worst thing that ever hit since this damn COVID. You hear me? Crack is horrible and it's terrible. And, you know, even though, you know, we make movies about these things, they're real. And I just want to shout out to all of the families that didn't survive from, you know, that horrible crack cocaine and all the legacies that didn't survive. The families, people that are recovering, shout out to them. Those that didn't recover, I mean, crack cocaine changed our lives as we know it. And, you know, I hope one day that we never see it again. But today we're talking about filmmaking. You're watching frame by frame the real deal in the movie world with your true boo. And sometimes I get emotional, that's right, and I start talking about the real thing, right? How we gonna keep these drug dealers away from our children and save our communities, because that's what's in me. That's what I'm passionate about, saving my community, my people, and people in general, because God is the light of the world. He loved us all. And I want to thank you all for tuning in to this special edition of Frame by Frame, our top five urban films. And we'll be back next week with five more of our favorites. I mean, let's face it, we got some great films in the urban community that weren't giving any love, you know, so we're going to show them love here on Frame by Frame, because that's what we do. We show love. And today we're showing love to our top five urban films. Baby, we set it off. You hear what I'm saying? We talked about New Jack City, baby. We got the juice, all of that. We ain't gonna be a menace in this society. We talked about our favorite top five films. We ended it with our number one out of five, which was New Jack City, baby. Nino Brown. Don't be a Nino Brown out there, okay? If you wanna see Nino Brown, pull out that old good New Jack City, you know, or better yet, just go to our YouTube channel and watch Frame by Frame. We'll show you all the clips you want of your favorite number one out of the five urban films. And you have tuned in to your hit film show, Frame by Frame, the real deal in the movie world, with your true boo, the queen of TV. Don't miss us next week, because we're going to have some more of your favorites. And if you ever want to see our archive shows, you can go to our Facebook page, Frame by Frame, The Real. That's R-E-E-L, deal in the movie world. The Real Deal in the Movie World on Facebook. Or you can go to our YouTube page and watch your favorite show. I'm your number one brand ambassador in all the world, your true boo. Peace. Thank you.